Hi everyone, in this video we're going to review the adult cardiac arrest algorithm. Now the algorithm starts with chest compressions. Quality ACLS depends on quality BLS, performing quality chest compressions. You're going to provide an airway, assist ventilations, and get the pads on them as quickly as we can so we can assess the rhythm. Now, if it's a shockable rhythm, administer the shock. Immediately after you administer that shock, resume chest compressions. We're not checking a pulse, we're not looking at the rhythm, we're gonna get right back on the chest. Chest compressions for 2 minutes. During those next 2 minutes, while you're performing chest compressions, our goal is to gain vascular access, either IV or IO. After 2 minutes, we reassess the rhythm. If they're still in VFib or a pulseless VTach, we're going to administer another shock. Immediately after that shock, resume chest compressions for the next 2 minutes. During those next 2 minutes, we're going to administer our first drug, which is epinephrine, 1 to 10,000, and we can administer that every 3 to 5 minutes. There's no maximum dose. Every 3 to 5 minutes, we're going to administer epinephrine. Additionally, we're going to consider an advanced airway. This is our second shock, so get an advanced airway. I kind of favor the King tube for this. We'll talk about that more in another video. So, continue chest compressions for 2 minutes. Reevaluate, is it still a shockable rhythm? Shock the patient again. So, after our third defibrillation, we're going to administer amiodarone. This is an antiarrhythmic, and you're going to administer 300 milligrams rapid IV push. So if you look, the first medication we administer was a pressor, epinephrine. The second drug we administer is an antiarrhythmic, amiodarone. So in order, pressor, antiarrhythmic. If we kept going and we're going to give another drug, we'd go back to epinephrine. Then amiodarone again, the second dose. Pressor, antiarrhythmic. Okay, now we've defibrillated this patient 3 times. We've got IV access. We have an advanced airway. We've administered a pressor and amiodarone. We really need to focus on why this patient is in a cardiac arrest and try to treat that reversible cause. So if in your initial assessment the patient was not in a shockable rhythm, were they in asystole or PEA? PEA, remember, pulseless electrical activity. That's a rhythm on the monitor that you think they should have a pulse, but they don't. You're going to continue chest compressions because the patient doesn't have a pulse. Administer epinephrine, first drug, 1 milligram of 1 to 10,000 concentration, and consider getting an advanced airway. ET tube or a King airway may be a very viable option. Continue those chest compressions for 2 minutes, then reassess the rhythm. If it is a shockable rhythm, administer the defibrillation, resume chest compressions immediately after the defibrillation. Now, if your patient remains in a persistent asystole or PEA, our goal at this point is try to identify and treat any reversible causes. Go through your H's and T's. Try to identify the cause and treat it. Should your patient experience ROSC, a return of spontaneous circulation, you're simply going to move into your ROSC algorithm and support the patient. Okay, so 3 critical areas we need to focus on in this algorithm. 1, minimize interruptions in chest compressions. Somebody needs to be beaten on this guy's chest.
Good trick is to pump to the tune of Staying Alive by the Bee Gees. Do you know that song?
Yes, I do. I love that song. First I was afraid, I was petrified.
No.
2, immediately after we defibrillate, we resume chest compressions. No waiting, get back on that chest. 3, medication administration. First drug up in a cardiac arrest, a pressor, epinephrine. Second drug, if we need it, an antiarrhythmic, amiodarone. I'm Mark, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.